When I saw Iron Man, I just sort of went, oh, wow, okay, this is a whole new take. I felt the same about the second one. And then so when I was asked to be involved in the third one, I really went, oh, yeah, okay, if I'm going to do something, this feels like a world that I want to enter into. And I just think Robert has wonderful, you know, he's a genius, and I just think he's a wonderful performer, and Gwyneth too. So yeah, it was very exciting to sort of track the movies and then become part of the team. I just think he handles Tony Stark perfectly. I mean, he's, you know, he's kind of everything that you want. He's everything that I want a sort of a leading character to be. He doesn't take himself too seriously, but he's completely and utterly able to take the story seriously enough when it's necessary. He's charming, he's funny, he's irreverent, and he has a sort of an unpredictable quality, but Robert does anyway, has an unpredictable quality about him. So you just never quite know what you're going to get on screen. And I just think he just treads a beautiful line with Tony Stark, where he honours the character that already existed, and he gives you something that's incredibly entertaining and witty. You know, he's witty and sharp. It's funny, when I first started talking to the guys at Marvel, I wanted to get a little history on Killian and sort of see where he fit in the whole scheme of things, and which I did. They sort of forwarded a whole ton of material, you know. And I find on any film that I work on, I can only ever go so far with research, because there comes a point where I need to leap off from that and then get into movie world for me. And so, I really just needed to understand Killian in the comic strip world, I guess. But then, as I say, sort of let it go and really see what we were going to do. Well, Killian's an interesting character because he's somebody who was brought into this world with a number of disabilities, primarily physical disabilities. So, you know, so he's somebody who is trying to overcome obstacles. And I guess, you know, people react to that in different ways. And he is somebody who is not really accepting of his physical disability, and kind of has a big brain. He's, you know, he's somebody who goes, I know there's a better life for me than this. And so there's a real driving force to change who he is, to really kind of get out there and become a different person. And so we find him at the start of the film, you know, it's like a flashback, and we sort of see the ambitious, he's a kind of almost annoying guy that he is, and he takes opportunities to, you know, to try and latch on to people like Tony Stark. Well, I never feel like I'm Robert's intellectual equal by any means, so thankfully the script enabled that. But, you know, Robert he's brilliant. You know, he has a mind that works at 1,000 miles an hour. It's slightly tricky because he likes to improvise a lot and I like to learn my lines. So I was always a little thrown if there was something new thrown into the mix. But at the same time, everything he comes up with is amazing. There's no doubt about it. So you can't deny that if there's a better idea in front of you, you've really got to go with it, you know. And I've been a fan of his for 25, 30 years or something. So it was very exciting to work with him. And I always say one of the best things about being an actor is working with better actors. You know, he's a wonderful talent, but he's also really inclusive. You know, he's very generous in sort of wanting to make sure that what you're doing is the best you can be doing. And, you know, he's not selfish. He's not sort of caught up in his own thing. You know, he's really genuine and open. So it was a great experience, to be honest. I've watched her in films for years now and have always thought she was unique. You know, she's unusual, she's beautiful, but not common, you know, as far as her way of performing and how she looks, etc. So she's very special. So it was very exciting to get to work with her. You know, she's a smart girl, and so things that, you know, if there were beats that weren't quite making sense, you know, she was always coming up with great ideas. And she's very open, you know, she's very open to kind of, and she's done this before. I mean, the interesting thing is, coming onto a film like this, you know, you're working with guys who have played these characters before, so they're very familiar with what's going on. So I think they're very, you know, like Robert, they're very open, Gwyneth particularly, open in making you feel very comfortable in entering their world, you know. So she was a treat. Well, Shane's, you know, he's a guy's guy. He's really sort of, he's a smart guy, you know, he's a writer. So he and I often had discussions, and I'm sure other actors did as well. I often find, you know, with lines of dialogue, you get what they're totally going for, but sometimes they just don't come out of your mouth particularly well. You know, another actor might not have the same issue, but I might, you know. So I'm always looking at slightly adjusting the dialogue just to really make it work for me. And Shane was very helpful in that regard as far as, you know, coming up with different sort of ideas or... but he's, you know, he's a smart guy. He knows where to put the camera. He's got a great sort of energy about him and, you know, very sort of easy to get along with.